trenches. You can't throw dirt on the underground, we thrive in it. Ghana boys stocks on the rise, Charlie, this flex no day ready. See, we wanted to ride nobody with, we the ones who started with it. Translation, Yanni had to buy a Yanni at Yanni hits. This goes so hard, even the ops go with it, That's how you know we lit.
Zuma, they're proud of my people already. Tell my see Ellie. Me, I'm just sharing my journey. I'm thankful the people they hear me. Tribe of Joseph, I'm ahead of the bunch. P5, I was starving for months. A running cut team, both of my pockets. Me need my...
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Dallas Cowboys and the Las Vegas Raiders. Of two of the more fervent fan bases around, the Cowboys and the Raiders are underway. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. First play is Prescott. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. And it's a terrific return here as he's going to have him set up with a first and goal right at about the 6-yard line.
Well, just one snap in, partner, and the complexion of this game is already changed because for the defensive side, they just handed their weapons a short field and a big early advantage. And even though it's only the first snap of the game, we're going to look back on this one and see if it has lasting effects as this game moves on.
Suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Carr, a quick throw, it's complete. He'll get only two there, and it's second and goal.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall, let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now Carr, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Trayvon Diggs, and the Cowboys are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line.
Well, Brent, as they say in popular culture, this one's going to leave a mark because they can see the end zone, but it'll stay out of reach because of their error. All their offensive teammates have to give the quarterback right now, offer a little bit of encouragement because what's done is done. Let's get them next time out.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10. And able to get it across the 20 before they get to it. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
But no matter your experience level as a quarterback, you throw an interception on that first drive, maybe a little shaken up. Nice response there to get their first down.
I think you make an excellent point. I don't care who you are.
You throw an interception, it's going to get to you a little bit. But the ones that we've seen that are the best, you never notice it. They don't come to the bench, throw their helmets, they'll do any of that. Just go back out the next drive, act like it never happened. And that's what we're seeing here.
The two big plays right in succession as this one goes for 27. Prescott looks to throw on first. And he rifles one incomplete.
And now the comments say, at least on this drive, a momentary setback, though, for this passing game that has been moving well this series. Good thing for them, though. Still two more downs to connect and try and pick up another first down.
Prescott's throw complete into the hands of Schultz here. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. Prescott. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle comes at the Raiders 23. A first down throw for Prescott. Another one to CeeDee Lamb. He's got it. Touchdown! Dak Prescott with a connection to CeeDee Lamb. And the Cowboys are on the board first here in Vegas. Bouncing back nicely from that bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number two leads him right down the field and into the end zone.
So obviously his confidence was never lost, and that's a good thing to see. Great quality to have. You absolutely must maintain that as a quarterback. But I have to think that they're probably still on the script that they prepared for this game. Just the second drive. They've worked on these plays all week in practice. Put them to good use on that one.
Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. Things a lot different than the last time they were on the field. Remember, they threw the interception, gave up the touchdown, and now trailing 7-0 and looking for a response. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down. Throw knocked away and incomplete.
And that's a nice job there because you've got to play the ball, not the man, when in coverage. That'll keep you away from a lot of needless penalties, and he's able to knock that one away.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Carr. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Malik Hooker, and they will take over at the 29-yard line.
But it's certainly not giving much help to their defense, are they? Because for the second time now, that D has had to run back out on the field early after an interception. And remember, on the last drive, the opposing side took it in for 6 after that interception.
And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
Brandon, you know this is going to be discussed because this is the fear of all the backs when they run this type of a route. They've got to find the football, and sometimes they don't see the defender. And in this case, he took a pretty good shot for his efforts, but give him credit, able to hold on to the football.
Throwing left side, it's complete. There they are able to stop it, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a 1st and goal.
Quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Yes, sir. How about an outboard there on 1st down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
2nd and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Throw left side complete. That's Schultz. And he is going to lose yardage here. It'll be a loss of 2 on the play. And that'll bring up a 3rd down and goal. It looked like the defense, they were ready for that one.
Really left him almost no room to work after catching the ball. He could throw every move in the book at him.
tackling for a loss.
Prescott on third and goal. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked by Trayvon Mullen. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. So from one end zone all the way to the other. Talk about a turnaround.
And how about the excitement that that play generates for his team? Not just the points on the board, but the momentum and taking it from coast to coast, end zone to end zone. What a tremendous play. Now get that man an oxygen tank.
That's your boy Old Mo, you said momentum, right?
Old Mo, I think he's kind of limping across at the end because of that distance, but he made it.
We'll see a return here from the end zone. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. 7-7, our score after one. This next drive by the Cowboys offense. Back to it after the pick six. Prescott. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 32 on the play. First down, Cowboys. Prescott now. Eluding the pressure right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's not like pressure to affect the accuracy and the timing of a guy trying to throw the football. And on that play, they ended up flushing him to his left, contacted him as he's trying to throw the football, and that led to the incompletion.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
And just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
On third down, Elliott. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So after a good run by Zeke, another first and 10. And they'll give him another shot here on the ground. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Looking to throw. Prescott. That's going to be caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Two first half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have taken the lead.
The catch and the touchdown, they were the end result of a terrific route run by the receiver.
Marr on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Following the touchdown, here's Marr to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15. Set to get this drive started. And job one here, Charles, just keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic.
Look at this. Middle of the field. A breakaway. The 30. 10. 5. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. They blitzed defensively there, but he was able to slipped through that first layer, and then he was gone.
I think they won the leverage game, didn't they?
Yes.
Right? They saw the blitz coming. That got to him a little bit, but they leveraged it perfectly and found not just a crease, a gigantic hole. And off he goes, and he's still going all the way to the end zone.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone.
The Cowboys make over first down at their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
On second down, Elliott. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop it behind the line. The offense on third down today, they've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. He's going to rifle one deep left side. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. So how about this for a change in field position? From inside the 10, here's first down on the other side of the field. Now Prescott. He'll get this out wide here to Elliott. And they're going to move it down inside the 25. So the completion good for 7 there. And that will bring up 2nd down. Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. Again to Elliott. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of 2, 3rd and 1. A couple extra tight ends in the formation here as they line up 3rd and 2. Prescott. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Jonathan Abram picks it. And the Raiders are going to take possession here. It's a touchback. And they'll take over at the 20-yard line. The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. Now after the INT, it's Carr. A dump off for Abdullah. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards. The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. To throw his car. He goes underneath to Abdullah. And this will be good for a pickup of 9 to the 46.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
That's good.
Now Carr. And for the 3rd time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown. And the Cowboys are going to take over here at their own 22-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively of getting inside a quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
They take a shot downfield there, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Good defensive call right there because they had so much shadow along his entire route. And he was right there ready to provide a hit that prevents it from making another catch to his big start.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Now Prescott. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked off by Nate Hobbs. And he's giving his guys a shot for 1 point. It's over a takeover in range for a field goal, maybe more. The Giants are so close to halftime there. You throw the interception out of the net. You do give it to them in plus territory as well.
Yeah, they were pushing real hard to try and get something more on the board on their side of the ledger right before the half. Looking at it with 20-20 hindsight, though, might have been better to hand it off a few times, hoping to get something to break instead of putting the ball in the air and, of course, putting the ball in jeopardy. How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago. Followed up with another nice one here. And before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
The kick by Carlson is good. And that will do it for this first half. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break.
Both teams making their final adjustments before we get started once again. And for the call of the second half, let's send you back out to Allegiant Stadium and Brandon Gott.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. The second half is now underway. Phillips, he's not going to bring this one out, so they will begin the drive at the 25. The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Running straight ahead is Jacobs. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
And off to the races down the right side. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. And that run going to put him over 100 yards now for the ball game as well.
Yeah, he's really had his way so far, and that's just more of the same right here. All he needs, just a little crease, and off he goes.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And his guys will take a 10-point lead. Following the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Carlson. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, the opposition laid down the challenge, an opening drive touchdown here to start the second half. And Charles, now you feel like this group needs to get an answer because this all of a sudden is a two-score game.
Yeah, you're right about that. What was a small magical spread to overcome? A little bit more daunting now. I think you're exactly right. Pressure is on because you don't want them getting the ball back with a chance to really extend this lead out.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they throw it. Now with a short passing game, you should.
And now here's another interception. Jonathan Abram picks it. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Surprise back up in the game when he threw a second interception. I mean, who would have thought a quarterback of his caliber picked now 5 times?
It's beyond stunning to me because we're used to that with maybe a quarterback with less experience or less talent, but a quarterback of his caliber, I can't believe what we've just seen.
Absolutely. If you would have told me this coming into the ball game, I would have said never, not in a million years, but here we go. First and 10, here's Carr. The throw taken in by Cole. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here. Working with a second and 3. Here's Carr. Looking left side and he's got a man. That's Jacobs. And the Raiders are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Here's Jacobs, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. One more time with Jacobs, and that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. Here's Carr to throw, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked up by Leighton Van Der Esch. And the Cowboys are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line. Boy, he had to fit that into a pretty tight window over the middle. And, Charles, I think they were in zone defensively, weren't they?
They certainly were. Nice read on your part. And sometimes the quarterback isn't fooled between zone and man. Sometimes just fooled by the type of zone that he sees. Because oftentimes,
and my goodness, another interception. Jonathan Abram picks it. And the Raiders are going to take over. Yes, folks, that is his third interception. And I'm going to use one of his overused phrases in football. He's a ball-hawking safety.
I love the way that you called for the shot there. That's perfect, though, because there is something to that. Being a safety often allows you freedom to roam around a defense, maybe not a specific assignment. Today, his assignment, find the football, and he's done so quite well.
Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield. We're playing 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. He releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
And he'll get nothing out of that one. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's 3rd and 10.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
It's complete. Abdullah. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. 5 yards, not enough, and it'll be 4th down. Here's A.J. Cole now, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt.
And this will depend on the spot as it sails out of bounds. And they'll say it sailed out at the 10-yard line.
Let's go old school there. That's absolutely a great coffin corner punt. Someone's put some time in working on that, hasn't it?
Seems like every year these guys get better and better. It's amazing how they can command that football through the air.
Yeah, they used to actually practice with hula hoops where they place them and try and put them there. Now a lot of guys use barrels on the sidelines to try and put the football in.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
First down, Prescott. That is caught by Lamb. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They'll throw again. Prescott. And that was going to be off target and incomplete.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here on this drive. But a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive.
On second down, Prescott again. And now here's another interception. Picked off by Trayvon Mullen. The number seven injury lucky here. Seven picks he's thrown in this game. That's only happened six times since 1960.
And I know that the most recent time it happened, the guy who threw him, he won a Heisman Trophy in college. So sometimes you just have a lousy game. Doesn't necessarily mean it's a bad career. But when you're talking about one game, seven, you're right, not lucky at all.
Yeah, Ty Detmer, the last to do it in 2001 to throw seven picks. And he'll get it down to the play to the 37. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Now Carr. He finds his man complete. It's Jacobs. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Going to give it to Jacobs, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
I have to chuckle to myself a little bit, Brandon, because right now I could be in that huddle with that offensive line. I know exactly what they're saying. If you call a pass play here, we're going to call a timeout. Run the football. We got control of this thing. Get in behind us and let's go.
Their time to shine. 149 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. Carr going to look to throw. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by Malik Hooker. And the Cowboys are right back in this football game. I'm starting to wonder, Charles, if five interceptions, is that the last that we've seen of him?
Well, I think that a lot of people hope that's the last they've seen of him in this game, probably including himself. If this were baseball, the manager would have been at the mound already and asked for the ball, and he'd be in there getting a shower. But in football, you might have to go stand on the sideline.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Nate Hobbs. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. And this defense just continuing to do their thing, and now they add on to that lead with another pick six.
And how about the way they've played this entire game? Not only they put their stamp on it, but every time they try and mount an offensive challenge, they find a way to thwart it. And multiple pick sixes? Oh, yeah, they'll enjoy watching this tape after the game.
This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. At their own 19-yard line.
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Max Crosby, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. To try again after the sack, Prescott. And his throw here is incomplete. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense, they're just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
He's got his man. It's Gallup. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. They'll get 19 out of this, but it will still bring up a fourth down. Desperation time. Prescott on fourth. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. They had to go through with such little time remaining, and the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. The Raiders likely going to get out of this with a victory as they take a knee. And now with 6 seconds remaining, they're going to burn their final timeout. Down to a knee, and that ought to just about do it. So this one's a victory for the Las Vegas Raiders. That was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought that that would be their last points of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they plan to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever it was, it all came together in the second half, and no points were allowed. That's a great